We're in a field of trees right now that have been sheared conventionally, but a few of the trees with shorter tops still have their natural bud on them. The research we've been doing last year and this year with leader control, we've been using a chemical to keep the tops short enough to where they don't have to be pruned. The advantage of that is you keep all the buds. You keep that dominant crown bud with the strong lateral buds, and you keep all your lateral branch buds. And it's concentrated in a shorter top. What would be the advantage of that? It would give us a more dense tree and maintain the highest potential bud set for a tree. Valent Biosciences has developed a synthetic form of abscisic acid. Abscisic acid is a plant growth regulator that controls the top of leaders and elongation of shoots, and is actually involved in a lot of different physiological mechanisms in a conifer. We've been testing its use to control leader height. Valent first started working with Christmas tree growers in Europe to see if the abscisic acid could replace other chemical pruning agents. Traditionally, for the last 10 years or so, European Christmas tree growers have been using a plant growth regulator called NAA. And this new one from Valent Biosciences promises to be more effective. They've done the work in Europe, and it's already a recommended practice now on Nordman fir. The company's interested in taking the work that was developed in Europe on Nordman fir and seeing if it could work as well on the different fir species we grow in the U.S. for Christmas trees. When we're using the plant growth regulator to manage the tops of trees, we may be increasing the number of buds by a third to almost as much as a half, because we're keeping the concentration of buds at the tip of the leader. It has the potential to do a whole lot for building tree structure and density. Using the easy roller is a really efficient application technique. We're only putting plant growth regulator right where we want it put. However, I'm afraid it's also an imprecise method of application, and it depends on how hard we squeeze the leader as we run it up and how fully charged that roller is full of product when we make the pass on the tree. This year we were able to put out the plant growth regulator study at three different locations, one in Avery, one in Ash, and one in Jackson County. Of course, we had hoped to be able to show the one in Jackson County on the NC Christmas Tree Association Summer Farm Tour. But I was very pleased to be able to work with our growers. We worked with Mitch Poe, we worked with Scott Presley, and we worked with the Cartners and Ronnie Bean. The rates we used this year were different from what we used in 2019. After last year's results, we had a fair amount of damage where we burnt tops, burnt bark, and killed some tops. So our rates were lower this year. We also tried a double application of our lowest rate. Treatment timing is different for the abscisic acid than what we would do for mechanical pruning with clippers. We need to treat while the leaders are still elongating. So you watch top length and you come in when the leaders are about an inch or two away from what you want for your final height. Depending on the number of rainy or sunny days after bud break, trees could be at the ideal height in early, middle, or even late June. Here's a video of Katie Ashley treating tree tops with the easy roller applicator. One pass on one side is all that's needed. We have to be careful not to put too much out, or we could risk damaging the top. So we think a light touch is probably better than a heavy hand.
Now I'd like to show you the results of the abscisic acid studies we've done here in North Carolina. First, the 2019 results. This chart shows the average increase in leader growth after treatment. It looks wonky because we actually observed negative growth. Many injured tops were shorter when the treatments were made. However, we did have uninjured trees that showed the hoped-for height reductions, but there was a lot of damage last year. The 2019 damage results follow accordingly. We used a damage rating of 1 through 4 with light, moderate, severe, and dead damage categories. There was almost no observed injury on either check treatment. There was a strong injury rating effect among the abscisic acid treatments, with a lot more injury at the higher rates.
Here's the 2020 tree damage data. And again, we did some damage, but you can see that compared to the previous year, the damage was much worse at the higher rates, and we had very little damage at the lower rates. So in terms of tree safety, we're moving in the right direction. However, now when you look at the actual height suppression that we got from the treatments, you can see again that we had better suppression at the higher rates and not quite adequate suppression at the lower rates.
But still some suppression. It's interesting that the 2x5% rate yielded the same average level of suppression as the 10% rate. Keep in mind this is 1 month data, and we still have another round of measurements to make this year.
So unfortunately, I still think we're needing to look harder at this and figure out possibly a more reliable way to apply it, or we don't have the results we need yet to be able to go commercial on Fraser fir. While we're not quite there yet with the recommendations for Fraser fir, they have had success on some other fir species grown here in the U.S. Of course, the work on Nordman fir has translated very well, repeating what was done in Europe, and it's also worked well on noble fir in the Pacific Northwest. I hope one day that we can integrate some of these new technologies like chemical pruning that will allow us to keep the full set of buds that nature gave us on a Fraser fir. However, we're not quite there yet, and I'm afraid we're going to need to do more work. But I still think it's important for us to try these technologies and see where they fit in our existing production practice. And it's a new world with a lot of opportunities to change and maybe improve how we produce a Christmas tree.